As couldn't have looked more confident as when they arrived at the arena earlier on. Obviously amped up for tonight's game. And the game arrival, sponsored by Express. Dress like a pro. The Margaret Hunt Hill Bridge and the state flag of Texas looking majestic tonight. We're coming to you live from Dallas, Texas. Welcome, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports for this NBA presentation. And tonight we'll see the Dallas Mavericks as they go up against the Utah Jazz. This is Kevin Harlan with Hall of Famer Doris Burke and Greg Anthony giving us the rundown from the sideline courtside, David Aldridge. And let's check out a breakdown looking at some stats for Clarkson.
In the last five games, you can see the trend upwards for effective field goal percentage. And it shows you how confident he's playing right now.
And nothing tips off a broadcast like getting the lowdown from the sidelines. And we've got David Aldridge there for that. David, good evening.
Head coach Quinn Snyder is trying to help the Jazz break through in a crowded Western Conference. Snyder said, "There's always challenges, and I'm comfortable with adversity. I just want to keep the right perspective. I've got something that I love to do." And Kevin, he is one of the biggest reasons the Jazz is always a factor.
He is doing a great job. Thank you, D.A. Both these teams, Doris, relying tonight on the execution in their half-court game.
A little bit of a throwback, sort of an old-fashioned approach tonight. Don't worry, we're going to have plenty of highlights. It is the NBA. We know there are great players on both sides of the ball, Kev, but how about this ability to execute under duress of a 24-second shot clock? It's going to be really interesting to watch.
And checking out Utah's opening lineup, Mitchell is the two with Ingles at the three. Gobert is out there with Bogdanovich, and it's Conley in at the one. And for Dallas, Curry is out there with Jalen Brunson. Then there's Tim Hardaway Jr., and there's Porzingis, and it's Finney-Smith in at the four spot. Here's Conley. What a tremendous game he played against Houston. Gobert trying to get open. Porzingis with the block. Curry against Mitchell. Brunson kicks to Curry. To the paint. Shot clock at six.
There is an imagination, a creativity. This guy's passing drives the offense.
And here is Conley. Pass to Gobert. Back to Conley. Ingles against Hardaway. Mitchell outside. Shoots over Curry. The shot, no good. Now the Mavericks take it the other way. They defeated Charlotte in their last game.
Yeah, they were able to maintain focus in a hostile environment, and that led to taking shots that made sense.
Well, I'm sure they're still enjoying that one. You love going into a tough building, tough place to play, and shooting the lights out. Nothing like silencing the crowd.
Great teamwork, punctuated by a strong finish.
Going right to the rim, which is where you want transition opportunities to end.
Now here's Conley, and he can be counted on to put some points on the board every night. He's averaging right around 13.5 points a game.
Boy, when you talk to his teammates and his coaching staff, Bojan Bogdanovic, one of the toughest guys you'll see in the league. He doesn't say much, kind of stays to himself, but boy, when the ball goes up, does this guy compete.
Two shots. Last on the first.
The first free throw is good. And growing up a young child in the violence of Croatia during the Yugoslav wars, Doris, Bogdanovic said it affected everyone.
Not only that, Kevin, but think about it. This is a young man who at 16 years of age left his home on his own to go play pro basketball in Madrid. And what does it translate to? Well, he can now speak four languages. I'll tell you this, Bogey knows a thing or two about resiliency.
Probably as close to a sure thing as you can have at the free throw line.
The pass to Finney-Smith. Curry against Mitchell. Outside, Porzingis. No good with the triple. It's been a slow start here for Utah. Trailing by five. Coming into this, having notched a win against the Rockets in their last game.
And in that one, the offensive execution made the difference. They found and exploited the mismatch repeatedly.
Well, it was certainly a game that their analytics people had to love breaking down. I thought they exposed every weakness in the defense.
One falls for Mike Conley.
Guys, when you think about the Jazz, you are talking about an elite defensive unit. Rudy Gobert in the middle, the defensive player of the year, and the guys around him are committed to the scheme and outstanding individual defenders.
And so Mike Conley nails both of them. And the Jazz very disciplined at the defensive end.
Now, Kevin, you have a veteran squad with the anchor Rudy Gobert, one of the elite shot blockers in the entire league. And this is a group that's so important here. They defend without fouling.
And the Jazz pushing it up now. Mitchell wide open. That misses. Had a chance to tie it there. Hardaway passes to Kerr. Porzingis with the ball, covered by Mitchell. With the fadeaway. And it goes down 2 points.
Boy, how pretty is that at 7'3"? Kristaps Porzingis knows he can get his shot anytime he wants.
And Gobert kicks to Mitchell. It's rebounded by Dallas.
Well, conversions have been a problem. 0 for 4.
And denied. He sends it right off the glass. Hardaway with a wide open look. Offensive rebound Mavericks. The wide open look here for Porzingis. And too long on the shot.
Normally he'll drill that shot, and I'm sure they'll look to find him in that spot again.
No doubt. Very good play call. Good execution. Sometimes it just doesn't fall.
And the Mavericks with possession here. Following the bucket by the Jazz. Bogdanovich against Curry. Pass to Brunson. Outside Hardaway. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
Well, think back to before he moves on to the Dallas Mavericks. While Tim Hardaway Jr. was with the Knicks, he was carrying such a burden offensively because Porzingis was still recovering.
Shooting 2.
First one falls for him. And we've seen Hardaway be a much more efficient player than in the past.
What we know, Kevin, unequivocally, is that this young man can score the basketball. But what you hope is the best players in the NBA are all about efficiency. That's what you want Hardaway Jr. thinking about. How can I be the most efficient guy on the floor?
Hardaway hits them both. Around this time of year, lots of national broadcasted games, Doris. Does that impact the players, you think, in any way?
I certainly think the guys are aware of the nights they're on national television. Some guys relish, Kev, as you know, the opportunity to play on the big stage. So for the regular season, those nights where you know the entire country is watching, that's a big deal. Boy, at some point, you've got to realize there might be a better option standing next to you. This guy has not made one basket in this period.
Now here is Conley. He dishes it to Mitchell. Passes it to Gobert. A shot off that time. And it's Dallas the other way. Last time they met was in Salt Lake City, Utah, where they fell to the Jazz.
Well, I mean, they lost their last matchup with this team, and foul trouble really plagued them throughout the game.
Nothing wrong with aggression as long as you're smart about picking your spots. And let's see if they can be a bit more disciplined this evening.
Whistle blows. Basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play. That sends Porzingis to the free throw line. It's going to be on Rudy Gobert. And the impact that Porzingis can have on the defensive end, Greg, cannot be overstated.
The reach and leaping ability he has paired with his timing make him a premier rim protector. And what sets him over the top really is that fearlessness. He will challenge anyone and everyone at the rim.
That free throw good from Porzingis.
There is so much to love about Kristaps Porzingis. Over 7 feet, sweet shooting jumper, but aggression. This guy will back down from no one.
Now, here's Mitchell. He picked up 24 points in their last win against the Rockets in Houston.
And let's not forget about the assist. This guy is a playmaker, was a driving force for that offense.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over him.
Here's Hardaway, and then Hardaway with the dunk.
And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
I know it's early, Greg, but you have got to like the dominance down low. Right now, they are playing bully basketball.
And a first time out of the game called for Utah. And Doris, Porzingis not only quick to adapt to the NBA game, but also the culture.
I think it helps, Kevin, that he got tutored in the English language starting in grade school. And think about it, Kevin. This man wore his hair in cornrows back then, emulating the NBA players he saw. So both linguistically, culturally, and basketball-wise, it wasn't too big an adjustment for him.
Maxi Kleba, he's checked in for the Mavericks. Barea comes in for Jalen Brunson. O'Neal's checked in for Utah. Jordan Clarkson comes in for Mitchell. Now here is Conley. And Gobert kicks to Clarkson. Conley against Porzingis. Another miss by Utah.
A team's rebounding is a great measure of its energy. And theirs has been terrific here in the first quarter.
Here's Barea. Gobert with the block.
This is Gobert's specialty. Twice on the pipes from the stifled tower.
Bogdanovich looking around. He kicks it to Clarkson. Right side, Conley. Can they get it? And Curry pulls it down. Curry's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight.
Boy, with his shot not falling right now, it might be time to look in a different direction. See if you can get your teammates started.
And what a way to start this game, dominating at both ends of the floor.
And give them credit, Greg, for approaching this game with the right energy and intensity. This team has attacked every chance they've gotten.
And the Jazz call time here.
We know this about the Dallas Mavericks. They will put every piece of data and information to use in terms of trying to get an advantage. Think about it, guys. They are now doing blood tests, trying to head off injury for their players. They believe this gives them a clearer picture into the overall health of their athletes.
On the Mavericks with some changes. Justin Jackson comes in for Hardaway, and it's DeLon Wright in for Curry. Utah also making some changes. Davis comes in for Bogdanovich, and it's Moutier in for Mike Conley. O'Neal passes to Moutier. Clarkson with the ball. Will it go? It's good, and he makes his first shot of the game.
It's easy to say, this guy wanted it more, creating the second chance opportunity and cashing in.
Barea, the pass to Porzingis. Barea, no good. Jazz trail by 13. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Well, Jordan Clarkson's handle has improved, and that allows that kind of move to happen.
Barea kicks to Kleba. Pass to Jackson. There's the pass to Barea. Now here's Porzingis, defended by Moutier. Porzingis can't hit. Utah's gone 0-4 from three-point land to start out, looking cold from outside. Moutier passes to Clarkson. And here is O'Neal. 1:56 left here in the first quarter. Off the mark, had a chance to trim it to single digits. And the call will be against Emmanuel Moutier. That is his first foul of the game.
Yeah, that's a tough call right there, and really a tough break for the D.
Willie Cauley-Stein, he's checked in for Porzingis. We've got 1:48 left to play here in the first. And it's Moutier with the ball. He brings it up for Utah. 11-point game. Knocked away. Pass to Gobert. It's a hand on it. Davis on the follow. Davis has got his second bucket tonight.
Oh, how about the finesse there? Nice little gentle touch on the board.
And you know, when you have that gentle touch, those tip-ins are easy to come by. Now, here's Barea. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Over Moutier. Dallas again missing.
And that one gives them a +5 rebound advantage, Kevin.
Inside. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Jazz will retain possession. Teams value the three so much nowadays. Let's check out the best at it. The Jazz, number one.
The threat of deep shooting makes everything easier offensively. They've been incredibly accurate from long range.
56 seconds left to play in the first quarter. O'Neal kicks to Clarkson.
Yeah, but the defense is doing a pretty good job of contesting those long-range shots.
Pass to Barea. Moutier against Wright. Back to Barea. Another miss by Barea.
Boy, what a nightmare quarter for this guy. He's playing right into the hands of the defense at this point.
Trying to get something going. Gobert with the block. Moutier against Wright. Moutier dishes to Davis. Here's Gobert. Count that one.
Gobert has a thin frame, but make no mistake, he is physical and he relishes contact.
That one's not going to go. And so it's Dallas, bringing the quarter to a close with a 7-point lead. They've set the tone. They love their tempo. They're going to be very tough to stop. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. Rudy Gobert talks about his expectations for the team.
Every day I want to keep getting better, and you know, people didn't really believe in our team a few years ago. They were kind of, you know, laughing at us. When I say I want to win a championship, people are laughing. But I believe that we're going to win a championship.
Well, and as a competitor, this is what you should be thinking. And, Greg, you should be talking about winning a title.
For sure. I mean, it'll take a lot of work, but Gobert sounds like he's up for the challenge of proving the doubters wrong.
And thanks again for tuning in. If you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter of action so far. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from the Mavericks?
What we saw in that first quarter, they won their matchups defensively.
I think across the board, a number of guys have done a great job guarding multiple positions.
They've got Willie Cauley-Stein. J.J. Barea is out there with Wright. Then there's Jackson, and it's Kleba in at the power forward position. So that's who Dallas starts the second with. Now, here's Clarkson. Last game with 30 points. Shoots from 12. Kept alive. Gobert. And slam dunk by Gobert.
Well, there's a certain amount of awareness that you're responsible for having when you're Rudy Gobert, and he makes excellent use of his size right there.
Here's Kleba. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game.
Boy, he cannot get anything to fall, but the teammates, boy, have they delivered. Well, the Jazz's Quinn Snyder has become one of the most respected head coaches in the league. And think, guys, a player poll even had him ranked 7th among coaches they'd like to play for. And consider he's in Utah. That is not exactly a free agent destination.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
Now, Moutier. He's still scoreless so far in this one. To the inside. 5 to shoot. Inside. O'Neal with the rebound. And Doris, what is it, do you think, about Quinn Snyder that gives rise to that respect?
Well, you think about it. He played the game at a high level, of course, collegiately at Duke. He has paid his dues as a coach. He's got tremendous intellect for the game. And there's this growth mindset with him. He's always looking at himself. How can I get better?
Moutier passes to Davis. Clarkson picks to Moutier. Down low, pass to Gobert, over to the wing, from about 19 feet, and they force the shot clock violation. Great D.
A brief check now of the stats for Rudy Gobert. He's been on a remarkable tear this past month, putting up about 18 points per, 14 rebounds, and just over 2 blocks. And on both ends of the floor, he's a guy they look for to take up space inside.
Well, certainly with the rebounding, with the ability to block shots, basically he does all the dirty work so the other guys can look pretty.
And Dallas calls their first timeout of the game.
And the playmaking of Joe Ingles, such a valuable asset for the Jazz.
Well, Greg, they've needed more shot creation, and his growth in that regard, especially operating in the pick and roll, such a big lift to their offense.
And the Mavericks will go for a different look here. Dorian Finney-Smith's checked in for Maxi Kleba. Tim Hardaway Jr. comes in for Jackson. Seth Curry, he's checked in for J.J. Barea. And it's Jalen Brunson in for Wright. So Utah going with an almost entirely new group here. Bogdanovich, he's checked in for Rudy Gobert. Joe Ingles comes in for Royce O'Neal. Mitchell, he's checked in for Jordan Clarkson. And Mike Conley subbed in for Emmanuel Mudiay. Curry gets the bucket.
Well, you cannot let Seth Curry have room to shoot on the perimeter. You are asking for trouble.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Now here is Conley. Brunson covering. With some arc. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Let's remember that Donovan Mitchell's first love was baseball. His father played in the minors, coached in the majors. Donovan himself was a star player in high school. It wasn't until he broke his wrist that he decided to dedicate himself to the game of basketball.
Free throw drops for Mitchell. And Doris, you mentioned baseball, where he played pitcher and shortstop. But Mitchell doing just fine, I think, in basketball.
No doubt, Kevin. He's come a long way since high school, because back then he was a power dunker and defender. But his transformation into an elite offensive player in the NBA, this is just a credit to this young man's work ethic.
And Mitchell drops them both. We hear this a lot, Doris. The great offense always beats great defense. Think that's true?
I do, Kevin. I think obviously a defender is usually in reactionary mode. It's the rare defender who is dictating to the offensive player what they want to happen. So imagine trying to impact LeBron James as he's playing in the open floor with a head of steam. Like, good luck with that.
Yeah. And here is Conley after Tim Hardaway made that last 3-pointer. Davis on the follow. Davis has got 8 points. Dallas leading by 9. Now here's Brunson. He had 13 points in the win against Charlotte. To the middle. And Conley gets it to go. The assist from Bogdanovich.
Well, how about the court awareness from Bogdanovich showing off his ability to find the open man, Kev?
Brunson the pass to Hardaway. Back to Brunson. And there's the pass to Porzingis. Curry against Mitchell. Shot clock at 5. Hardaway for 3. And he's good on the 3 ball. Hardaway has got a couple of 3-pointers in the second for Dallas. Conley with it. Kicks it to Mitchell. Porzingis with the block.
This guy is showing great potential as a rim protector. Porzingis a threat to block shots anywhere, anytime.
And after that ragged first quarter, they're getting some momentum, some confidence. Nice throw.
Here is Conley, following the score by Dallas. And the shot is good. The Maverick lead has been cut back down to 10 points after they get the bucket from Davis.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Now here is Hardaway. A 14-point game for him in the win against Charlotte.
He was also an excellent setup man as well. This guy was cutting the defense to shreds with incredible passing.
Of the two offenses here tonight, you can tell theirs is just a bit more in sync.
And I think because of that, they've gotten the better looks to start this basketball game.
Conley's shot is off.
He couldn't believe how open he was. He just couldn't convert it.
On the wing, Hardaway. Ingles covering. Brunson, good. Brunson's got his second basket of the game.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Outside, Davis. Mitchell outside. That's tipped. Lays it up and banks it in.
Well, it's a level of concentration that has to happen for you to finish through contact. Donovan Mitchell doing work.
Dallas leading by 12. Brunson kicks to Hardaway. To the paint. Here's Finney-Smith. That drops and it comes off the assist from Hardaway. Hardaway has got 3 assists now in this one. And so it's Conley bringing up the ball for the Utah Jazz. Davis, the pass to Conley. Back to Davis. And it's Davis with the jam.
Man, he's a pure point guard with terrific vision. Conley finds open teammates at times before they realize they're open.
Now here's Curry. A 26-point game for him in the win against the Hornets in Charlotte.
And the other thing, guys, he really got after it on the backboards. What a complete game for this guy.
Now Conley. After Tim Hardaway missed from long range. Loads it up for Davis. The Mavericks moving it up. Brunson with it. Conley picks him up. Offensive rebound. Here's Finney-Smith. Up and in for the basket. Number 4. That makes him 4 for 5 now.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
And the Jazz call time here. Nice game. Great performance by Tim Hardaway Jr.
Well, I think this is a necessary timeout so they can figure out a way to limit the impact this guy's having from three-point range. They've got to dedicate more resources to their perimeter D.
Dallas making a switch here. Lights checked in. Then for the Jazz, Rudy Gobert, he's checked in for Davis. O'Neal comes in for Joe Ingles. And it's Jordan Clarkson in for Mike Conley. Out of bounds, Dallas will take possession. And the upcoming schedule for the Mavericks. On Wednesday, it'll be the Sacramento Kings coming into town. Then on Friday, they'll tip off a road trip starting in Orlando and going up against the Magic.
And that game against the Hawks, that's going to be one where it would take a lot of errors and maybe a cold shooting night for things to go wrong. They just have that much of an advantage over that team.
Now here's Wright. Taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 7.5 points a game. And Jordan Clarkson is going to pick up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. And the Mavericks with some changes. Maxi Kleba, he's checked in for Dorian Finney-Smith. And Barea subbed in for Curry. Here's Porzingis. 7 points in the game. Right side. Just 4 to shoot. That shot is off. Ready by Bogdanović. O'Neal kicks to Clarkson. Here's Bogdanović. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down.
Well, Bogdanović looking so comfortable close to the rim. Just extends past the defense beautifully.
Pass to Porzingis. 55 seconds left to play here in the second quarter. Passes it to Hardaway. Over Mitchell. Dallas, no good that time either.
Well, if the defense gives him that shot next time, they could get burned. I think he's just a little bit out of rhythm.
16 feet away. Mavericks with the rebound. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points.
What a brutal night for this guy, and it is having a ripple effect throughout the team. This is tough.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
And that's typical of this guy. He's always reading the situation, reacting quickly, and capitalizing.
Now, here's Mitchell. Great numbers on a nightly basis as he averages over 24 points a game. Nice D from Porzingis. And the first half is now in the books. Mavericks lead by 14. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Kevin, thanks. Here with head coach Quinn Snyder. Coach, what adjustments are you going to do in the second half?
You just got to keep playing, keep taking the shots, and that's not the issue as much as us not executing on offense. And when we don't score, sometimes our defense lags as well.
Everybody wants to see the ball go in the basket first, right? Thanks, coach. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the third quarter.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey again, everybody. So far, a pretty lopsided game, but still one half to play. I'm Ernie Johnson, joined by Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. It was a big-time first quarter from Tim Hardaway Jr. He had 16 points, 3 assists, and 1 rebound. And Kenny, what are your thoughts on how Dallas played?
Well, they were dishing out dimes left and right, and the guys were finishing strong. As a team, they seem to be always thinking, always looking for the best shot. If they keep sharing the ball this way, the second half could be more lopsided than the first.
How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Utah?
Well, they struggled in a number of areas. Protecting the rim is really at the top of the list. They haven't made that a priority. They haven't put forth a whole lot of effort. You got to protect the rim.
And that'll do it for us. The third quarter about to begin with Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll catch you on the flip side,
my brother.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. Nice game, great performance by Tim Hardaway Jr.
And if he can keep shooting from deep like he did in the first half, he's going to be more than a handful.
What I love is they've continued to feed this guy, ride the hot hand until the defense does something about it.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be.
Well, you think the ownership style of the Mavericks, something the league had to adjust to. Very active, very outspoken. Sometimes I think that rubbed people the wrong way. But now you get the sense it's almost the new normal.
While we've got a moment, let's set the floor. Brought to you by Gatorade. All fueled up for the second half. So on the floor for Utah, Conley and Mitchell, the talented backcourt pair. Bogdanovich out there with Joe Ingles. And it's Gobert in at the pivot, manning the middle. Here's Brunson. Rudy Gobert picking up that last basket. And the Mavericks, we know, have been trendsetters, investing in development and in technology.
Kevin, they have always been on the cutting edge of data collection and then using that data to give them a competitive advantage. When you're in a business, it's always about what's next? How can I be better?
Hardaway finds Curry. And Curry with the stuff.
This guy's a really clever penetrator. You have to be aware of Seth Curry's craftiness on the drive.
Pass to Gobert. Mitchell outside. Down low. Gobert can't hit.
Pressured that shot by getting a hand up just as good as a block.
And he did it without fouling, and that's become an art, changing shots without making contact.
Now here is Hardaway. He's got 16. Rebound, Utah. Gobert's got rebound number 8 now on the night. And the shot is good. The Maverick lead has been cut down to just 10 points on the bucket from Bogdanovich.
Well, you have to like the balance of Bojan Bogdanovich. Keeping it through the contact. That is nicely done.
Now here's Brunson. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. The pass to Curry. To the middle, Finney Smith. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. Finney Smith's got 10.
Well, the coach loves this kind of ball movement. Anytime you create something inside the free throw line, you know it's a good look.
Gobert dishes to Bogdanovich. And the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
Everything going to plan here to start the third. 80% shooting thus far.
The Jazz have been perfect so far from the free throw line. 6 for 6. Cauley Stein, he's checked in for Dallas. Jackson comes in for Tim Hardaway Jr.
What's up?
Free throw good, Bogdanovich.
I think most people consider Salt Lake City not a big free agent destination. So the Jazz are what they call a pipeline team. And what does that mean? It means they have to draft and develop their talent internally.
The Jazz making a switch here. Moutier has checked in. Here's Moutier. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. 3 minutes gone now in the third quarter. Gobert finds Conley. Pass to Gobert. Clock at 6. Utah needs to get off a shot here. Conley's shot is off. And the Jazz say they need a fundamentally sound process to building their roster. Doris, no shortcuts.
Well, there's no question about that, Kevin. This is a group that has to be value-spaced with their free agent acquisitions in a small market. The draft picks have got to be smart. Their teaching and cultivating of that talent and development is absolutely critical.
For Dallas, they have made 3 free throws so far. Haven't missed any. And the free throw, no good. Doris, as you always say, there is a grace in handling wins and losses in this game, isn't there?
You know what, Kevin? There's an old saying that winning and losing are imposters, that it's everything to do with how you react to constant learning and growing experiences. And listen, everybody wants to win, but can you experience losing with grace and dignity? Can you embrace the joy of pure competition? To me, that's one of the beautiful things about the NBA. Men handle heartbreak and joy and set an example for the next generation. It's beautiful.
Curry against Moutier. Gobert, the pass to Conley. Here's the teardrop. He shoots again. Gobert can't hit.
Well, we didn't see the same kind of control we're used to seeing from him. This guy is usually a tremendous finisher.
Drains it from beyond the arc. Curry's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Boy, had this shot on automatic. The confidence so crucial to what Seth Curry brings to the table.
Here's Gobert. Not going to go that time. Cauley Stein with the defensive effort. Here's Jackson. Off the left rim and out. Jazz trail by 12. Outside, Bogdanovich. Passes to Ingles. And the rejection by Cauley Stein.
You better come stronger than that. Cauley Stein, a presence defensively.
Curry against Moutier. Finney Smith can't get it to go. Enzo Conley will bring the ball up for the Jazz. They'll be playing host to Miami for the next game. Stolen by Brunson. Jackson has the open look. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. Curry's got 6 assists now in the game. Conley kicks to Bogdanovich. Back to Conley. And it's good, 2 points. Conley's got 6 points.
Gotta admire how clever Conley is. Gifted at catching the defense off guard with that soft floater.
And the Mavericks call time here. And over the course of his career, Mike Conley taking on more and more of the leadership mantle.
He's embraced it, Kevin. And he said letting his hair down was a way of letting go and just being confident in himself.
A different look for Dallas. Maxi Kleba, he's checked in for Jackson. Barea comes in for Curry, and it's Wright in for Jalen Brunson. O'Neal's checked in for the Jazz. Jordan Clarkson comes in for Moutier.
And looking at some numbers for Wright, how's the last month of basketball been for him? He's averaging about 7 points a game, 4 assists and 4 rebounds. And when he takes over at the point, he really keeps the offense flowing.
Well, this is a guy who brings a solid skill set. Excellent ball handler, high level of playmaking, the perfect backup point.
Conley gets the bucket. Mavericks leading by 11. And here's Barea. And there it is for him. Barea's got his second basket of the night.
I'll tell you, J.J. Barea has the ball on a string. Listen, we know he's got a diminutive size, but his movements on the dribble, that's a big man's game.
Here's Clarkson. And the rejection by Cauley Stein. Barea looking for an opening. Kleba, the pass to Finney Smith. Conley against Wright. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Cauley Stein. Stolen by Clarkson. No one near Conley as he lets it go. And it's off from 3-point range.
I know he's got to be frustrated right now, but the team is fighting from behind. He's got to stay with it.
Barea, the pass to Wright. Good, Dallas needs to get off a shot. And here's Barea outside. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. Gobert's got 11 rebounds in the game. Good! O'Neal's got his first basket of the night.
Well, you won't see that kind of shot fall very often. Thank your lucky stars.
Here's Cauley Stein. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Finney-Smith passes to Wright. Here's Finney-Smith. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. Jazz trail by 11.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Kev, you love the strong shooting of Bogdanovich, a polished player with a scorer's mentality.
Cauley Stein kicks to Kleba. And here's Barea outside. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Barea's got 5 points in the quarter.
And guys getting into a nice groove here, starting to feel it.
And this is partly what the game has become, right? A matter of dueling three-point opportunities.
Here's Conley, and he gets it to go. Conley's got 10.
Well, Rudy Gobert stands 7'1", and he's an unselfish guy. It puts the pass on the money.
And he's going up for the alley-oop. Clarkson against Barea. A nice shot by Bogdanovich.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
Here's Barea. Here's Cauley Stein. Makes it off the glass. And the Mavericks lead by 9.
And with his vertical reach, you expect Cauley Stein to be a factor on the offensive glass.
Clarkson passes to Gobert. There's the dish to Conley. They get a hand on it. Inside. A nice shot by Barea. And it's an 11-point Dallas lead.
Wow, has he flipped the switch at halftime. Much more effective here in the second half.
Now Conley from deep. And he got that one up in time, but doesn't go in. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. It's Dallas up 11. And we'll get going after this from the American Airlines Center. And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. And it's the Mavericks with the ball. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points. We've got Hardaway. Wright is out there with J.J. Barea. And there's Porzingis. And it's Finney-Smith in at the power forward. That's the lineup in the game for Dallas. 11 feet away. And it's Mitchell missing.
Well, seized up just a little bit at the last second. That's one he normally converts.
A nice shot by Barea.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
Now, here's Mitchell. Pass to Gobert. On the clock. A fadeaway. The Mavericks pull it in. Porzingis has got 11 rebounds in the game. And then Hardaway with the dunk.
Yeah, they're rolling right now. That lead continues to grow.
And one of the things that's helped that is they're getting it done on both ends. Terrific focus on offense, and they're locked in defensively.
Now, here's Mitchell. That shot off. Nice D from Porzingis. We've gone about a minute and a half into the fourth quarter. High arcing shot, and it's Wright missing. Jazz trail by 17. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions right now. They need a basket.
Occupying that instant offense role, Doris, Jordan Clarkson able to get his shot anytime.
No doubt, Kevin. He's a little bit of a streaky scorer. The challenge is on the defensive end. That's where he has to really improve if he's going to stay on the floor and impact winning.
Free throw good. Clarkson. Dora, such an honor to be on this with you, and you were the first female to become a full-time NBA analyst, breaking new ground. You've accomplished so much in your life, personally, professionally. What would you tell young women who are graduating college, looking to get ahead in their career in what you've chosen?
Well, first and foremost, I've been very lucky, Kevin. The game of basketball has been a part of my life since I was seven. It's been a driving force. I love it. I would just tell young women, times are changing. Dream big. There's nothing that's impossible. And I'm so thankful to the NBA players and coaches who have just wrapped their arms around me from the time I entered this business. So kudos to those players who are part of the change, no question.
And hard work. I have seen you work. I have seen you prepare. No one prepares more. No one works harder than you.
Thanks, Kev.
Now here is Hardaway. And the pass to Brunson. Back to Hardaway. It's stolen by Gobert. Now, here's Clarkson. Tight defense on him. Dishes it to Gobert. Five on the clock. It's stolen by Curry. Pass to Brunson. Back to Curry. Poke loose. And here's the fast break. Clarkson leading the way.
Mitchell understanding that length and athleticism serves him well on the defensive end. Nicely done.
Passes it to Hardaway. Outside Curry. Shot clock at six. And here's Porzingis for a three. Shot clock reset for Dallas.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed.
Clarkson passes to Gobert. Add another make to his scoring column. His fifth basket of the game. Now shooting 5 of 11.
Rudy Gobert, an athletic monster. He fends off the defense with an amazing finish.
Here's Hardaway. Off the mark, and the drop continues. Jazz trail by 11. Now, here's Clarkson. Porzingis with the block. Brunson with it. A floater. That shot, no good. And Utah the other way now. O'Neal passes to Ingles. Good on the shot, and that shaved the lead to single digits.
I'll tell you, Ingles is just such a pro. This guy is unafraid despite the defense.
And the Mavericks call time here. And during this timeout, I'm sure they'll be hydrating themselves with Gatorade. All the effort out there on the floor, and these timeouts can be such a huge factor in getting a short rest and recharging the battery. All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
During that last break, Kevin, I got a chance to hear Rick Carlisle's message to his team. He told them, this is a game of runs. It's a game of momentum. We may have the lead now, but I'm telling you guys, it can evaporate in a hurry. Let's close this thing out. Kevin?
Now here is Hardaway. Curry kicks to Porzingis. Dallas, no good that time either.
Well, it hasn't been the most efficient game for this guy, but their team is fortunate to still be out in front.
The shot by Clarkson, no good. Mavericks leading by 9. Here's Brunson. And just miss after miss right now.
Not his best game, but they're still getting it done collectively.
Clarkson finds Ingles. And he uses the glass on the layup.
Joe Ingles has a great feel for understanding when to shoot the jump shot or when to attack off the bounce. That is not bashful right there.
Now here's Brunson. Porzingis passes to Kerr. Outside Hardaway. No good from outside. Jazz trail by 7. There's the feed to Clarkson. Count it. Clarkson's got 6 here in this quarter.
Nice little run here to shrink that deficit, but can they get over the hump?
Yeah, it feels like they've ramped up their intensity. They have forced good things to happen. Now they're back in it.
Hardaway from outside. The rebound by the Jazz.
In the first half, he was on fire from range, but he hasn't knocked one down since.
The shot by Clarkson, no good. And here's Curry, who brings it up for the Dallas Mavericks. 17 points was their biggest margin.
And with that basket right there, it brings an end to that 12-0 run by the Jazz.
And the Jazz call time here. Chance now to recognize our Jordan player of the game, Tim Hardaway Jr.
And his touch from long range has been money. Yeah, he's totaled 4 three-pointers on a very efficient night of shooting. And that's what turned a good game for him into a great one.
He's played up to his full potential tonight, and he's been playing to the crowd too. He loves being the star attraction, even if it doesn't happen on a regular basis. Jazz trail by 7. Pass to Gobert. Conley scanning the floor. And here's Gobert. Just 5 on the clock. They get it again. Mitchell. Porzingis with the block. They retain possession.
And Kev, Bogdanovich has got great size for a guard, which makes defending him very difficult, particularly at that high release point.
Shooting 2.
Throw good, Bogdanovich.
And even though they're down, they are putting on a show at the free throw line.
And that one goes in. 2 from the line that time.
And guys, Bogdanovich, the former second-round pick, has really found his place in the NBA. This guy is an effective shooter from just about anywhere.
Now here's Brunson. Now the pass to Finney-Smith. He dishes it to Kerr. Outside, Porzingis. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. Curry's got his 8th assist here tonight. Now here's Conley. Brunson covering. Outside, Bogdanovich. Has to go bare. Fades back. Porzingis with the rebound. Porzingis has got 14 rebounds tonight. Going after to the inside. The 17-footer. And so the ball is out of bounds. Bogdanovich touched it last. Porzingis looking it over. Launches a three, but they recover it. Finney Smith can't get it to go. Jazz trail by eight. Mitchell right side. And then Mitchell with the dunk.
And Mitchell doesn't waste time. He sees a chance to finish with authority and doesn't pass it up.
Runs in the pass to Porzingis. Here's Finney Smith on its way from Curry for two. And that one hits back iron. Outside, Bogdanovich. Here's Conley. To the middle, Gobert. That's in there. Conley with the assist. And now it's just a four-point Maverick lead.
Rudy Gobert is so competitive. Doesn't want to let a big moment go by. Nicely done.
Brunson, the bounce pass. There's Porzingis. That doesn't go either for Porzingis.
I'll tell you, this has not been his game, and he's making it worse with shot selection like that.
Mitchell's shot is good.
He might be young, but Mitchell is clutch. That's beautifully done.
Now here's Brunson. Passes it to Porzingis. And out of bounds as the Jazz gain possession.
A huge turnover at really the worst possible time. You have to value every possession, especially at this stage of the game.
Utah calls timeout. They trail by two. There's 49 seconds left to play in the final quarter. There's 49 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. On the wing, Mitchell to tie it up. The shot missing. Nice D from Porzingis. Here's Brunson. It drops.
So much riding on that shot. What a bucket.
I'll tell you, that changes things, doesn't it? Good job, young fella. What a game.
Utah calls timeout. They're trailing by four. 29 seconds left to play here in the fourth. 29 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Mitchell passes to Gobert. Back to Mitchell. There's the three. Utah the rebound. Good! And he has brought them to within 2 points.
Gobert is not fazed by these moments. He wants to be the man.
And they commit an intentional foul. We'll see another one of those so they can get into the penalty.
Yeah, you can't let them hold the ball and just milk those last seconds away.
And so they choose to intentionally foul. Free throw is good, and that makes it a 3-point lead.
Well, you have got to love the versatility of Kristaps Porzingis. Unbelievable shooting touch at 7'3", can also be a monster on the defensive end. Good luck, future of the NBA. You've got to show composure, and he comes through right when the team needs him most.
Conley with the three. That one, no good. So a close game sees Dallas taking this one. Probably a little closer than they would have liked it, but a win nonetheless.
Yeah, but I really got a sense that the fans gave them that emotional boost that was needed down the stretch. This crowd, man, they were electric.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. KP, you guys got out on a break tonight. How did you get into transition so easily?
Yeah, we want to play faster, and that's what we try to do whenever they miss. We try to run, move the ball quick, and get easy buckets.
And you were able to beat them down the floor tonight, KP. Thanks a lot for your time. Kevin, back to you.
All right, David, thank you. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Doris Burke, David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. We'll be right back.